People may know or may not know, but Futurama has lots and lots of mathematical secrets embedded in various episodes. My favourite bit of Futurama maths concerns a particular number, and it crops up everywhere. For example, if you look at the hull registry number of the Nimbus spaceship, it is 1729. The registry number has to be something, so what's wrong with 1729? Well, there's something odd about 1729, because if you look at Bender's serial number in the episode A Christmas Story, his serial number is 1729. There's another episode called The Farnsworth Parabox, I think, where Fry is popping out of different boxes representing different universes. And one of the boxes he pops out of is universe number 1729. So somebody at Futurama is obsessed with 1729. The person who's obsessed is a chap called Ken Keeler, or Dr. Ken Keeler, because he has a PhD in applied math. He went to Harvard. He worked at AT&T Bell Laboratories. He's published papers in discrete mathematics. He's a heavyweight mathematician, and he's a comedy writer, and he works on Futurama. The reason he loves 1729 is he's paying tribute to a great Indian mathematician called Ramanujan. And I know you've talked about Ramanujan on other clips, but just briefly, I'll tell you the story. Heroic mathematician from very impoverished background, really had very little formal education, but was a genius of a mathematician, but had nobody who could mentor him. So he wrote to lots of great mathematicians overseas. One day a letter arrived at the desk of G.H. Hardy, the great Cambridge mathematician. And Hardy looked at this envelope full of theorems and said, either this is completely fabricated or it's complete genius. And it was the latter. And Hardy immediately invited Ramanujan to sail over to England and join him at Trinity College, Cambridge. Hardy was no slouch. Hardy is basically credited with reinvigorating the whole of British mathematics, which was in the doldrums at the time. But Hardy himself says, you know, if I did one truly great thing, it was to enable Ramanujan to flourish. And so Ramanujan's in England and he's doing very well intellectually, but he's suffering physically. He doesn't like the diet here. He's a vegetarian. The weather disagrees with him. And the next thing we know, within a few years, he's in hospital, really quite seriously ill in Putney. And Hardy visits him in hospital. And as the story goes, Hardy gets out of his cab, sits by Ramanujan's bed. Being mathematicians, they don't necessarily have the most gossipy chit-chat. And Ramanujan says, oh, what was the number of the cab you arrived in? And Hardy says, oh, it wasn't very interesting. It was 1729. Now, I find it interesting the fact that he could remember the number of the cab, but that's another story. He says, oh, it wasn't a very interesting number. And Ramanujan says, no, quite the opposite. 1729 is a very interesting number, because it is the smallest number that is the sum of two cubes in two different ways. 1729, and it equals 10 cubed plus 9 cubed, and it also equals 12 cubed plus 1 cubed. It's rare for numbers to be the sum of two cubes in two different ways, and this is the smallest such number. So it's a special number, and Ramanujan, you know, I just had an extraordinary ability with numbers to be able to spot these patterns out of thin air. And for this reason, 1729 is called a taxicab number. And that's why Keeler embeds it in Futurama as a way of paying tribute to Ramanujan, who died, I think, about 6 months later. He went back to India, still in poor health, and died at a very young age. He just seems to have dreamt numbers and imagined numbers and thought about numbers continually. He did tell the story that at night, one of the Hindu goddesses, would whisper mathematical secrets into his mind. So whether it was an immense capacity to do mental gymnastics on the spot, or whether it was just part of his knowledge of math, I guess we don't know. You know, people who are watching this may know about Ramanujan, because people watching this may be very fond of mathematics. But beyond this little group we're in, people have never heard of Ramanujan. And yet, thanks to Ken Keeler and thanks to Futurama, there's a little bit of Ramanujan's legacy gets drip-fed onto primetime TV around the world. And in fact, Keeler's gone one step better, because there's one episode, I think it's Bender's Big Score, where Fry jumps into a taxi cab. And the number on the taxi cab is, let me just write this down, 87,539,000 319, okay? That's a taxi cab number in a literal sense. It is the number of the taxi cab, but it's also a taxi cab number in the Ramanujan sense, because it is the smallest number that is the sum of two cubes in three different ways. So it equals 167 cubed plus 436 cubed. It's also equal to 228 cubed plus 423 cubed. And it's also equal to 255 cubed plus 414 cubed. So we can call that a taxi cab number of rank three, is what I like to call it with a very, very bad pun. And you might want to go away and think about what is the taxi cab number of rank four. As far as I know, it's never appeared in Futurama, but it may well do one day, so it'll be a way of spotting it.
Simon, you kind of alluded to the fact that by doing this, the writer has raised an awareness to a possibly different audience about Ramanujan. Do you think that? I mean, has he raised awareness, or is it a hidden nod to something?
I think if you've never heard of Ramanujan and you're not into mathematics, these numbers are arbitrary, and you won't pick up on it. But I still think it's a tribute. I think it's a very personal tribute from Keeler. It's also him just having a bit of fun. It's an in-joke. I think Futurama viewers are probably a surprisingly high proportion of them will be interested in mathematics and will pick up on that reference. I remember one of the writers said that there was occasionally a bit of a dispute over mathematics in Futurama. There's a line where there's a holographic image involving, I think Kif says there are a million lines of BASIC there. And they were sat around the table in the writer's room and they said, you know, who knows about BASIC? You know, our viewers are never going to get that joke. And one of the lead writers at the time said, it just doesn't matter. If they don't get it, they don't get it. But those people who know about maths, who know about computer science, who know about some of the languages of computer science, they'll get it. And it'll be a bit of fun for them.
Do you ever do it yourself? Do you ever drop things into the things you produce with hidden things that aren't obvious to your viewers or readers? Or is that not the style of a journalist?
No. There are some references in my latest book, which those who know them will spot them, and those who don't won't. And those who don't won't have their fun spoiled. But there are references to a certain legal case that people may spot. But there we go.
This video has been brought to you by Audible.com and their huge range of books that you can download. You can actually get one for free by going to audible.com/numberphile. Check out the details there. And then what one are you going to download? Well, if you've not yet got a hard copy version of Simon's book, The Simpsons and Their Mathematical Secrets, maybe you want an audio version. Maybe you want to listen to it hands-free. You can't be bothered actually holding it. You can download that. Maybe that could be your free one. audible.com/numberphile. And thanks to them for supporting us. Some good Christmas reading or listening, that one. Very geeky.